Yo, what is happening? Welcome in. We're starting early tonight. We're feeling good here on a Tuesday. April 6th. Had a lot of energy today. Coming off the vaccine. Coming off the COVID vaccine. Dose one. Science, man. Crazy. Super pumped on that. We got a big night tonight. We're starting early. Have been sketching for the last 45 minutes or so. Moving to the iPad for some sketching so I can get in on these screens and really show you guys what is going on. Still the sketching ethos though. Let's see. Big week this week. Vaccine week. Masters week. Come on. Big week. Segment 8 tonight. NFTs. Non-fungible tokens. Likely the future. So here at MDS and Pencil to Pixel, it's exactly what we do. We're getting to work on the future. Let's see what else. Yeah, pretty much covered everything. Gonna pick out the tunes that we're gonna listen to tonight, right now, and then we're gonna get right into it early. But I wanna give us some extra time in order to get into the wireframes and get into more of the design work. And really kind of get a couple screens running good there. Gonna focus primarily tonight on the important stuff within the application. We're gonna leave the whole login screen app icon stuff for me to just do on the side. Look for that in the recap. Frank tonight. Starting in 1 minute for the NFT idea, so just bear with me, or fast forward. Let's see, what do we want to listen to tonight? Little Benny music. Never mind, found it. I had this last week too. All right. Got the tunes picked out. Gonna get the little keynote that I put together for this pulled up. Boom. All right, cool. So before we dive into the sketches, I want to give everyone a little bit of background on what an NFT is. It's a hot term, kind of like Bitcoin was a while back. Now that Bitcoin is definitely here to stay, we're going to talk about NFTs. NFTs are the hot thing on the market. I think an NFT a couple weeks ago went for like $68, $69 million. Serious. So we're going to go into what's an NFT and then get right into the sketches and then roll into more of the wireframing design work. So quick little keynote deck for you guys. What's an NFT? Let's begin. And an NFT stands for a non-fungible token. So think of an NFT as something that you can trade with your friends or buy off a market or an online market, something like that. So an NFT is traded through the use of cryptocurrency, Ethereum, Bitcoin. So that's where we have this. An NFT acts as a unit of currency and it's stored on the blockchain, which we won't get in here today because that will take me 20 minutes to explain. And then the art piece of it, NFTs are known as pieces of art that are not duplicated. There can't be two of the same NFT. And this is because an NFT comes with unique pieces to it, code, creator material, all of the things that come along with minting an NFT. And each piece of an NFT is one of one. So each piece of art is a one of one. Think of it as the Mona Lisa, right? There's no other Mona Lisa, even though there are replicas, this and that. There's only one real Mona Lisa. Got it. So, that with the lesson, the brief lesson out of the way, we're going to roll into the sketches. I'm going to put this down here, and I'm going to switch this over. And I want to show you guys kind of where I started, and then where we're going to hop into with the wireframe. So I started up here just sketching some very basic sort of like login screens. Kind of the top half of this whole thing is the login screens. So launch screen, had the idea on when something's loading or we give the user, as the app's loading here, we give the user the prompt to sign in or visit kind of the minting space, one or the other. I want this app to be focused more on the trading, the following, the keeping up on the trends, kind of where the arbitrage of the NFTs occur. So this is an idea where this would be a carousel of like NFTs being sold right now. And it'd be like one with all the details, and this would kind of be like a scrolling carousel. Log in, gonna capture a little bit of identifiable information here. This will not qualify as the real setup for this person's account, because what comes with the use of this kind of NFT platform would be verifying all sorts of information around payment, transferring, any sort of cryptocurrency that they currently have, all sorts of good stuff. So this is the bare minimum in order to just create an account. We're going to verify an email, and then this is where we get into more of the setup. So I want, obviously, this app to become kind of the single source for the marketplace aspect of NFTs. So what we do is we prompt someone to transfer or add all of their NFT purchases, pieces of art that they've currently purchased to the app. And then they can also add their cryptocurrency in the setup there to kind of bolster their profile right off the bat and bring stuff over from past or other accounts, other platforms. So now I kind of had two ideas in terms of the home screen. This is kind of the first one where I'm just giving the user a number of options. And so I'm giving them a couple of options. This is around, let's see, hold on. There we go. So this is around kind of the crypto part. This is an icon that I came up with for like some sort of network. And this is the trading aspect. Now that was like the first one, first home screen that I came up with. The second home screen that I came up with was right into kind of like a StockX feel, where we're right into one, your people up here that are in your network that are trading and interacting with NFTs and possibly trading with you in your own sort of NFT network. And then down here is kind of like all the NFTs that are bidding. So this is like kind of an infinite marketplace. And I imagine that there would be a feature up here where we could search and we could bring in some tags. So if I'm into basketball, I do stuff around like NBA, or I'm into Mies van der Rohe, so that could be a tag that I would add, or I'm into Frank Sinatra, or I'm into Murakami, right? So these are all things that we could add as tags. And then down here, these would be kind of this like zoomed out view of the NFT. So for that, I have just like a very simple rectangle with the NFT here in the middle. And then we'd have some pricing information, maybe like a trend arrow, if it's trending up or down. And then we could have like the current seller face or profile right here. This could be subbed out for like number of current owners. It could have nothing there. Like, we don't need to overcomplicate it. And then if I click on one of these, if I click on an NFT, I'd go to this kind of NFT detail page. So at a glance, what I kind of dreamt up if I were to purchase an NFT first I'd want to see kind of the whole thing. So this would be like a click to expand. And then down here, we obviously have price. Here we could have current owner or seller. Previous owners is kind of another network piece. Let's see. What's over here? What did I say? Button to make an offer. Boy, I got scribble in there. Button to make an offer. And then down here, when I was doing some perusing on sites like Mintable, I think is what it is. On each NFT, there's a set of like 101 items. So this is things like the creator, the date, and then there's like the code that comes along with the transaction. So all of this would be kind of below the viewport for the screen, but still available for the user to see. They make that visible. So from a high level, that's kind of what we came up with. Let's roll into more of the design work for this. I'm gonna bump the Figma window up here, bounce down, let's make this real big. So we've got the sketches. Let me move over a little bit. So we have the sketches there. Move over so we can get the full view here. Nice. Cool. So we have the sketches. I've just got a couple screens lined up, couple shapes, couple colors that I like. And then I also had some art, some random images off of Google. I'm not taking any NFTs off anywhere. I'm not copying anything. I'm just bringing some stuff off Google for examples, not for commercial use. And we're gonna let this go. So I have four NFT examples here that I'll work with. So let's work through some of the sketches. Let's start with kind of what we thought of as the login screen. So this would be kind of like name of app. Now this is the wireframe, so we're just going fast. I mean, the idea here is that we have this. This is some sort of thing. We've got a little bit of a button down here maybe to launch. We may have, yeah, right, like this would be the scrollable marketplace thing. Making sure we got audio here. Great, thanks. All right, so We're back to the wireframing here. Again, up in the sketching, I kind of had this like marketplace feature upon the launch screen. So if we're back to the next page, we're just gonna call this like get started. Let's get to a cap lock state. This is rough. This is just kind of the initial wireframing piece to this. So then we're gonna come up here. Let's get a couple fields going. Just going fast, not focused on style. We'll do that later. And then let's get another button here. All right, cool. So then we got like a little sign up form. What else? Could have a verification. Let's go to the setup page. So this is the setup of the account. These include things like transferring over past NFTs, current NFTs, mintable information, all of the cryptocurrency. So someone could transfer over Bitcoin, Ethereum. So I kind of have two things for that. And then these would be clickable elements. So then if we do, let's see, shift O or no, oops. Let's see, let's get a circle going here for some icon. Boom. What? Just going faster. I wonder why that won't come to the front. Weird. Weird. Huh, okay, well, you get the point. So we've got two pieces here. This prompts the user. We could also just prompt them to skip. So what I'll do here is just put a line down here. And this would just be like a piece of text, but we're going fast. So we can get to the design work. Let's see here. After that, we've got a couple of things. One was the idea for the first homepage, and then the second was the idea for the second homepage. So I want to go with the second homepage. I kind of like that idea. So what we'll do is we'll just make all of this very boxy here. Pull this down. Had the idea of including some, let's do 50 by 50. There we go. So we could do some friends. Let's do this. Nice. Cool. So we can do some friends, kind of like your network of people within the show. And then if we bounce down, I'm gonna pull this rounded corner thing over, and we're gonna do a 2x2 just for starters here. Nice. Okay, so we've got an idea for the home page, and then where else are we here? Oh yeah, detail page for let's make an arrow. Let's get in on this. Got a little back arrow. Let's bump that up a little bit. Yeah, there we go. And then we'd have this, the art piece be the primary part of this. So we'd make that real big and real nice. And then I envisioned kind of a, just something very simple down here. Just like a, some sort of 4x4 with bits of information in here. So let's see. And then down below here would be all of that kind of mintable information that we talked about. All right, so we've got a good chunk of the wireframes built out. Let's roll over to some of the design work here. And let's just see what we can come up with. Let's focus on, I want to focus on this screen. I think this is most valuable. And this one as well. We can come up with two screens tonight and a third. We'd be in good shape. So let's pick a color that I have here in the document. Got a pink, I got like this purple. And I'm going to, let's do 12, no. Okay, now we're just gonna get into some of the design work, so. Gonna get some faces going for you. Keep this, what I've been trying to focus on is a lighter drop shadow within some of my elements. So I'm working on just including like a less sharp, you know, just working on getting more of a, you know, just a softer shadow that still kind of jumps off the screen, kind of like that. Like that. I'm gonna flip the fill to white. Cool. And then here's where we're gonna do the NFT art. So let's see here. Let's see if I can't clip the content. Okay, so now we're rocking on the NFTs. So let me get those images. I'm gonna pick the Murakami one, pretty fresh. Let's get this rolling just over here. And then I also wanna create kind of a background, which is just bigger and wider, or we use this and then just make this smaller. And I'll show you why I'm doing this. All right, let's see here. Perfect. Nice, that's looking good. All right, so let's get rid of that. Let's get a little drop shadow going on this. Perfect. And then I did want some information down here, so let's just do, for simplicity's sake, let's just do a price. And then I get this kind of like neon vibe from a lot of the NFT stuff, so kind of on that wave. Let's see. Let's get a circle going in here for a little bit of an icon. Nice. Whoops. Make sure that's all good to go. Get a little icon going here for forgetting that that's not. Nice. We're going fast. Not worried about it. Obviously, this is not the right icon for a coin, but we get the idea. I mean, okay, so now what I'm going to do is just duplicate these 4 times over. Yeah, nice. Okay, we got a little grid going. No. I also want to add, all right, I'm going to go a little off script here. And let's get a little rectangle going. Get a line going. I'm going to work on kind of that tagging feature that I had in mind. All right, let's see. Okay, so we got a tag. And we could have another tag, but in reality, just want these tags to be we're kind of on that gray theme. Could keep it simple. Let's grab a piece of text. Murakami. Boom. And Mies Vandero. Let's do something else. Virtual. Okay. Rough sketch. So let's then create, because I'm just going to use the Murakami example as the example. Let's create an active state button. So what I mean by that is select the one that's active in terms of, not the blue. Yeah, let's do a white with a drop shadow on it. Why not? And then we'll make this text the pink. Knocking on your door. And then we'll just make these ones all probably not intuitive, but we'll come back to that. Now let's also go to this, pop this in here. I need to add a drop shadow to this. What do you think about that? Fire. Back to the effects, 10. I have 10. I just picked the color that was kind of up here. 20, 80808. Cool, let's roll with that. Nice, all right, so we got our home screen. Let's spend a little bit more time up here. What do we think about active state buttons? Go with a little MDS colorway here. Let's Let's make this a little stronger. Let's make this a little bit better. Yeah, let's go white. Let's go white. Let's make this a light text. Go. Nice. So then we have some sort of another one over here. And I kind of like the green I had much better. So now we got our detail page. We'd have some friends up here. Let's see what we'll be putting in the header. What do I have in the sketches? I also wanted to do a menu. Okay, let's see what we can do here. I kind of like the big border thing with this. I don't know why, but it's... It's kind of intriguing to me to have like just like a big border on this. I don't really know why. Would this look good with a border on it? No, I like the art to pop more. I like the art to pop. Okay, but we can have it on the menu. And we'd have... Let's do... Nice, so we're working on the screen here, and we're working on it. Okay, so a little bit of time left here. Let's flip over and take this over here and see what we can get going. So obviously, let's just take this out of the way. And then I had the idea to make this quite a bit bigger. And then still have some room for information down here. Want the art to be, I mean, it's a collector item, like I want it to be on the screen, like if I'm looking at that, I want to be able to see it. Okay, cool. So let's do that. And then what I want to do is sort of like an ownership tag in a way. I don't have images of people, but what we could do also to create kind of a community around the NFT is create sort of these are the people that have owned it. I know that'll be important too, especially from a status perspective of seeing who owned the NFT before you. I know that will be huge. Like, oh, LeBron James owned the NFT before me? Or, I mean, that's going to be ultimate status. So here we have kind of the highlight. I want to do another circle up here. Oops. Whoa. Let's do the white. Let's do a stroke it too. Keep doing it. Not the same commands. Command shift back. There we go. Okay. So, let's see. And then down here, I had the idea for like just some light information on the NFT. So we're gonna have to make these much lighter. And then let's see, back to the sketches. Had the price, current owner, seller, previous owners, make an offer. Okay, so intuitively I probably want to put the make an offer button down here in this side. I'm cool if the button runs out of the little grid that I have going on here. I think it's fine. Let's get this. Let's get this, and we're gonna make this a little bit. And then let's turn this to let's get this back to zero. Add this in here and then make sure that this is that took way longer than it should have. Group that, move that down. That's the make an offer space. So then I have the current seller being this person. And then we'd have some sort of a name here. And then what else? What else did we have in the sketches? Price, button to make an offer, previous owners. Now, on this piece of the detail, I may not even, what I just thought about is like, let's not even add any information on the price within the token. Let's just present the token like in this little framed setup, right? So then I had the idea of making all of the other spaces here kind of less significant to the, I don't want a stroke actually, I want a shadow. I want this at 10, and I want this at 08. Yeah, nice. So, let's just... Nice. Back one more. Keep going back. Okay. So then we have each of these little rectangles being like bits of information, but center all this, whatnot. Whoa. And then we have the previous owner guy. He'd be over here. So these would all be white cells, and then this guy would be the make an offer, which would be green. Yeah, I like that. That's cool. So this would be like Jared F, and this would be, let's black this out. Jared gets his profile photo because he owns the thing. And then I also wanted, so I had price, previous owner, make an offer, or place a bid, I guess is the phrase. Here we go. Let's get this bumped in. It's rough. Nice, okay. Place a bid, and then we could have that like sequence of previous owners up here, and then we'd have like a little piece of text. That'd be like plus 22 more. And we just put this very small, and we'd make that very small. And I think we'd probably even make it even smaller and less apparent. Let's bump this down. Great. And then I see this have, let's see if I can just flip this around. Nice. Okay. So. Let's see here. And then, so this would be the state for, these would be all the previous owners. Okay. So. And then down here would be, let's make this like even lighter. I want to make this like even less involved. Nice. I just called it Winking Flower. I don't even actually know if it's called that. Cool. Okay, so that's the detail screen. And that is, that's the overall screen. Pick the Murakami. I don't know, Winking Flower, I guess, just off Google. Okay, so in summary, back to kind of the beginning here with the NFT idea, we wanted to provide sort of an application in terms of a marketplace. So trading, buying, selling, following other people in terms of what NFTs they have, all that good stuff. So what we did tonight was we worked through the sketching, went through some wireframing, and then just picked out two screens. One would be kind of the landing screen for the user to kind of see the marketplace of NFT items. Pick out some of their, call these tags, but more interests. So this could be like, I don't know, any interest. I have Virgil Abloh, Murakami. You could be in the Beeble space. You could be in athletics, Nike, NBA, anime, whatever it may be. This would be kind of like similar to a stories, but I think this would represent more of like, if you clicked on this, you'd see a recent action by Ben, me. So I'd be like, I just traded an NFT, I listed an NFT, I bought an NFT. So then this platform also becomes a driver of social currency, which is really important in this space too, because I have a feeling this space will all become based on some sort of status. And then over here, we have, if we click on one of these in the marketplace, we go to the detail page, and then we have a number of options here. We have the price of the NFT, we have the current owner, we have the previous owners, and kind of a community feel too. And then we have the opportunity to place a bid. So that is, that's the recap for this week, segment 8, Pencil to Pixel. Thank you so much for tuning in. We started early, ran late, very excited this week, very excited. It's vaccine week, it's Masters week, it's NFT week, it's everything in 1 week. So I know you guys have busy schedules. Thank you so much for tuning in to the NFT sketching, wireframing, and designing a couple of app screens. Here every Tuesday at 7 p.m. Mountain Standard Time, Pencil to Pixel, where I take an idea that I have from sketch, wireframe, and work through to design and prototype it. Thanks so much for tuning in, and we'll see you next week.